Hey everyone, Haldrie here. Nintendo, what the hell are you doing? This new Nintendo Online thing doesn't impress me. I was sort of looking forward to it at first, but lately, not really. Because it seems like now you're trying to justify the need to charge people by dangling little carrots on a stick with cloud saves and this new NES library that you're once again going to trickle out to everyone. Stop it. First of all, the cloud save thing? We wouldn't need it if you just let us copy our saves to the SD card in the first place. If your justification is to keep people from cheating or hacking your system, implement some sort of encryption method like you did with the Wii U encrypting USB hard drives. You could have done that, or at the very least, encrypt the saves so that it's tied to the profile. Don't want people backing up that save and then reverting back to it later? Do a rolling encryption, where it changes the key every time and stores the latest key for that save on the profile on the system. A profile that we can't modify under normal circumstances. That will prevent all of that. But what the hell do I know? I'm just your average Joe Schmo that happens to know a whole lot about computers and encryption. Not an expert. I don't claim to be an expert about anything that I talk about. But if I can figure that out, why can't your engineers? That would be such a simple solution. Then all these people would not have had issues where their Switch suddenly stops working, but their saves are stored on the console itself and not on an SD card, and even you couldn't even recover their saves. Why couldn't you recover? Why couldn't you take the flash chip out and recover it? How was that a situation they had to be in, where they put 150 or more hours into Breath of the Wild and lost everything simply because the console they played it on had their only copy of the save and the console died? This is long before cloud saves even was mentioned by you at all. People, yeah, we're begging for it. But again, I get that it's, you have to pay for servers. I get it. I get that you want to charge for online because you just can't afford to keep doing this for free. I get that. And you know what? Your online service is very reasonably priced compared to Sony and Microsoft solutions. I would more than love to pay for it. But I'm not going to pay for it just because it suddenly gives me the security of making sure that my games are saved. What happens, however, with this portable system when I go outside of the range of a Wi-Fi connection? Put that back in sleep mode. I make some progress with a game in portable mode, maybe some decent progress, maybe put, 3 hours into Breath of the Wild, get some pretty good progress in it, progress I really don't want to lose, and yeah, now I'll kill my battery, because, hey, 3 hours, that's about how long it lasts on here, right? And then I drop it and the system breaks. How would cloud save save me then? Answer me that. It wouldn't. Should be the only answer. It won't save me. Because I'm not connected to the internet when I'm taking this on the go, because there's not Wi-Fi all over the damn place. And even if there was, well, that'd be one hell of a utopia if there really was. I step outside my house, no Wi-Fi. I have no Wi-Fi around here for a long time, for a good distance. So yeah, that wouldn't help me at all. And I'm not going to use up data on my phone for this thing. Shouldn't have to. One thing that would save it, let me turn this off. You probably already know what I'm about to do, because I've already mentioned it. Turn off, thank you. And off, okay. Is if my saves were on here. If my saves were on here, instead of on here, then if this broke, I'm okay. I just pull this out, and there's my saves. Even my installed games are on here. But no. You decided to lock them to this thing. This fragile piece of technology, which you intend for people to pick up and take with them. Your competitors, Microsoft and Sony, allow you to back up your saves to one of these. All of your saves. My Xbox 360 back here, there's all my saves, right there. I can take this and plug it into any other Xbox 360. This has my profile on it too. But you won't let us do that. You won't let us keep our stuff stored in a much safer location than the internal NAND storage of this thing. The only thing on the internal NAND storage of this, for me, are my saves and my profile and the profiles that I have on here. That's it. All of my games and all the DLC is on this SD card, except for my saves. My Wii U, you know, the previous console, all my saves are on this USB drive here, along with all the installed games. And yes, I hacked it. Yeah. I got it to hack. But I still noticed that all the saves are stored on the USB drive. Now, your solution was to fully encrypt the USB drive. And I suppose you could have done that with the Switch, but then easy access to the pictures and videos that you save with the gallery would potentially be compromised, so I can kind of understand that. You could have still encrypted it, though. You could have still encrypted the individual files, or had one big blob file for each save, or I don't know, figure something out. But no, it's on the console. And you know what? It's even encrypted on the NAND. If people want to cheat on a single player game, why? Why do you bother concerning yourself with it? If it's a single player game and it's not going to infect any online stuff, and I don't mean, oh, your gamer tag, achievement score, I mean actually affect the gameplay for other people, like an online match of Splatoon 2. Which, yeah, I'm with the community. I haven't experienced it myself. Anti-cheat. Put it in here. It's in the first game, apparently. Why is it not in here? So yeah, you're worried about people cheating from hacked saves? They are cheating already. Long before the cloud save system and paid online started. I'm sure they're still cheating. I don't know. I haven't played in a while. Pretty sure the last Splatfest I was in, we did have a group cheating. But all we can do is just report them after the fact and cross our fingers. I don't understand what goes through your minds, Nintendo. How you justify what you're doing. Because I love this platform. You see here, I have a small collection of games I've actually played quite a bit of. I even have some digital games Recently got Okami HD on there. Never have made any progress past even what I've gotten on that thing. I really do need to pick back up. I have a huge wish list of games that I actually already own on PC that I plan on getting for the Switch when I am able to save up enough money to afford that kind of thing. Which is why I've just left it on my wish list. But stuff like this, where I can't even back up my saves the way I want to, where now it's being held for ransom for cloud saves, which... Do you really expect us to trust that you won't mess up the cloud save system? Oh wait, you already did. This game is not compatible with cloud saves. Are you kidding me? Why? You control the cloud saves. Why is this not compatible? Because people might cheat? How? It's an online platform you control. This is an online game you control. How are people supposed to cheat it? Unless you're too lazy to put any kind of systems in place to detect it. I just had one of my friends reply to me on my Twitter post that I left for you. This is kind of what sparked this video in the first place. Defending you with all this, using the same BS marketing crap you do. Trying to justify why you have to do this, why all games can't be compatible. Then explain to me how Sony and Microsoft are able to do it with no problems. If it's not possible. Explain that to me. Because when your competitors can do it, but you can't, then what are you doing wrong? Is the only thing I can ask at that point. Anyway. I don't know what else to add other than to continue to repeat myself from this point, but at this point, what I've done is I've turned off the Wi-Fi of my Switch, and I refuse to update to 6.0. Because I am afraid of what will happen to my current ability to back up my saves. Many of you will probably recognize this thing. This is the jig for hacking the Switch. I have hacked my Switch. For one reason and one reason only. I want to back up my saves. When this became available, I jumped at the chance to be able to hack my Switch just to be able to back up my saves. But if I upgrade to 6.0, I don't know if the homebrew is going to work. It probably will. And yeah, it means I've lost access to the store. It means I've lost access to all of that stuff currently. But right now, I've got all these single player games that I can play while still on this firmware. And I can still back up those saves. So I'm going to lock it to that. Until I see some sort of positive change. I'm seriously considering, to hell with continuing to buy games for this thing, and I'm looking to see if I can purchase a Switch that is also still hackable, that I can play pirated games on that instead. That is what I've resorted myself to, is thinking in those terms of pirating games. Because I'm not happy with what's going on with this. Is that what you want to turn people into? Take your legitimate customers who had no intention of pirating your stuff and actually buying them like I did and turn them into pirates? Because piracy is totally a thing on the Switch now. Has been for a little while now. And people will find another way to hack this thing. Since you locked out that one from the newer Switches. People will find a way. And as long as this continues to be an issue, I cheer for them. I hope they succeed. Because this is ridiculous. These draconian methods of locking down your console are ridiculous. It makes me glad that I am as big into PC gaming as I am, because modern consoles are frustrating the hell out of me. It's why I don't own a PS3. And I'll be honest, if the Xbox 360, the way it is now, existed back when I got it, I probably would have thought twice about buying it as well. And as it stands, I have zero interest in ever owning an Xbox One or a PS4. But I did buy this. I did buy your console, Nintendo, because of the promise of something different, something potentially better. Not in terms of power, graphics capability, or anything like that, but in terms of the experience. Instead, what I'm seeing is something that potentially is far worse, because there is nothing worse, and I know from firsthand experience, there is nothing worse than losing your saves. Because if you are playing a very long game that requires many, many hours to be able to progress, and you suddenly lose all that progress, kiss me ever wanting to play the game again. Goodbye. That's already happened several times. I'm in the process of trying to find saves for some of my original PlayStation games that I've backed up thanks to Homebrew on the PlayStation 2. And memory card files that I've got through emulators. I have a progress save for the original Soul Reaver. Yeah, I've never beaten that game. I really did enjoy it. I got quite a bit far, but I can't remember if I played it on the actual system or an emulator, but that doesn't matter because all the memory cards I have were blanked out after I backed them up to my computer. In fact, all those saves are on this flash drive. All of my PS1 saves, and PS2 saves as well, are on this flash drive. I've already gone through and organized all my saves for the PS2 onto a few memory cards. But I don't have enough memory cards to organize all the saves that I have for the PlayStation. This is it. I mean, I have this, but anyone who's familiar with this knows this loves to forget saves a lot. So you do not want to rely on this thing. And you don't want to have to rely on this thing to keep your saves either. I would rather rely on this. I would rather rely on this. Something that is permanently fixed, connected to my, physically in my Switch at all times. Right there. My saves can be on that. And if my saves are on that, and I can take them to a new Switch, if anything happens to this one, 90% of my frustration is gone. I will happily continue to update this thing and play the crap out of it, and not worry that I'm going to lose all the progress and all that time that I invested in these games because my save disappeared because the system quit working. Because let's face it, you're expecting people to take these places where it can easily get broken. You've done an amazing job building this thing. I have seen people do teardowns and do stress tests of it, and holy cow, the kind of stress and torment this thing can put up with, I was really impressed with. But that doesn't mean that it is impossible for that to happen, because again, people have already lost their saves before the whole online thing was even announced, or at least the details of it. I'm talking about last year, before I even bought mine, because I bought this back in December of last year. I put a video up about it. So it hasn't even been a year of me owning this. But in that time, even before I owned this, people were already losing their saves because their systems were dying. Some of it was, yeah, maybe their own neglect. People experimenting. People using those third-party docs. One of the biggest reasons was because you chose to have this thing out of spec, which messed with the internal components, the charging circuit, apparently, because somebody did figure out what apparently the problem was and why those switches were dying, and it fried them. It fried a particular chip that controls the charging circuit of the switch and messed with the whole power regulation system, preventing the switch from functioning again. And I got fingerprints all over the screen, and it's bugging the crap out of me. I'm pretty sure if I updated this, I could still run that homebrew program that lets me back up my saves. My biggest concern is that will Nintendo ban me for it? Because see, here's the thing. If you ban me on this thing, all bets are off. That nice big wish list I have? Forget it. This small little collection of cartridge-based games that I have? That's as big as it's gonna get. I will then turn around and pirate the crap out of everything on the Switch if you ban me just because I'm trying to back up my saves. I don't want to hear the argument of why cloud backup is good. I've hated cloud backup. Okay, let me reiterate. I've hated the idea of cloud backup being the only solution. I don't mind cloud backup being an alternative, kind of to, okay, not alternative, a system that will, that you can use on top of being able to back up your saves locally. I don't mind that. Oh, I should have rehearsed this more before I actually got on video, because now I'm getting into something that I didn't even think about at all until now. And you can tell I'm frustrated. It's almost 3 o'clock in the morning. I was hoping to have already ended the video, but then decided to keep talking. I'm frustrated with the state of video games these days. I've got many rants that I can do, but I don't. I've sat here in front of my computer yelling at some imaginary person who can't hear me. Similar to kind of what I'm doing now, only I actually do plan on posting this video for the world to hear me rant and ramble, and oh, what am I thinking? But if we didn't love this stuff, we wouldn't complain. If I didn't love this thing, I wouldn't rant about it. But at the same time, I know deep down what I say here isn't gonna matter. That Nintendo will probably never incorporate local backup saves. At least not without some serious user backlash. And even then, they'll be resistant to it. I wish things didn't get this bad. I wish consoles were still systems that you could just pop your games in and play, like they used to be, instead of having to go through all this crap of accounts and profiles and... Whatever happened to just pop your game in and play? Why do we have to go through all that? Even portable consoles got messed up with that. The 3DS single user system did do the whole Nintendo account thing with it, which is good because it was better than what the Wii did, where if you lost your Wii, you lost your all your store stuff. I forgot to left that open. I want things to get better. I really do. I'm tired of these companies just doing this just to make more money and not actually considering what the consumer really wants or even considering why we want it. I want it because I want a better experience. I want this thing not to feel like a chore to own and to use. Because that's exactly what it feels like now. I'm constantly having to be concerned and make sure that I run the hack on this thing again so that I can back up my saves so I don't lose them. I do have recent backups currently, but if I put a few more hours into Breath of the Wild, I then have to turn around and hack the system again and make a new backup. I don't want to have to keep doing that. I don't want to have to hack my system just to back up saves. I shouldn't need to do that. I shouldn't need to rely on that. And I say again, I don't care about cloud saves. I don't trust Nintendo to do them correctly because they've botched online services too many times as it is. And if you've played Splatoon 2, during a Splatfest, you know the issues I'm talking about. The numerous connection drops during a major event. If they can't figure that out... Now, apparently it goes peer-to-peer with that, but... apparently it goes peer-to-peer because they don't have the dedicated servers to handle it. Which, again, I understand if that's the case of why they're charging for online. I got no problem with that. I got the problem with the fact that they are trying to bolster this up with stuff that should have already been included without making us pay this subscription service for it. So now that I've made my point with the cloud saves, let me make my point with the NES library. Because why, Nintendo, after all of these iterations of consoles, are you still making the same stupid mistakes? Let's release a handful of games and slowly trickle them out over the lifetime of the system. Screw that. I have a full set of NES ROMs and some really good emulators on my computer right now. I can load them up anytime and play them. I don't need to wait for your generosity for this. And oh, speaking of that, I can hack this thing, load an NES emulator on it, and play all the games I want. I can do the same for my 3DS that's hacked. I can do it to the Wii U. I got plenty of little platforms I can play NES games on. I'm not going to pay for an online subscription to be able to do it. Screw that. So you can take your NES games and shove them. People are already upset because you killed Virtual Console. I have no idea what their opinion is about this trickling out. I'm sure many of them are like, oh, praise Nintendo for giving us this service. I don't care. I really don't. You know what I have always thought of would be great for the Virtual Console? And yeah, I'm going to call it the Virtual Console, because that's basically what it is, a Virtual Console. It's an emulator. Something that we've been able to do for free for over a decade now. A couple of decades. Okay, maybe not quite a couple of decades. You know what I mean. I keep forgetting just how old yet young I am. Ugh. What I would love, what I would suggest to Nintendo to do, bring back the Virtual Console. But instead of this whole trickle out the games and sell them piecemeal like this, and at, you know, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 bucks a pop. Because, yeah, Pokemon Red and Blue really need to be sold at $9 each. And yellow. Red, blue, yellow. Red, blue, and yellow. 9 bucks a pop on the 3DS. That was totally a reasonable goddamn price. No, it wasn't. That was completely unjustified of why you chose to charge that much. Just because it has, just because it's Pokemon, they're Game Boy games. There was zero reason to charge that much for them. They're Game Boy games. But regardless, what I would suggest, sell the individual emulators in the store. Super Nintendo, Sega Genesis, NES, Virtual Boy, Game Boy, Game Boy. Sell those emulators 10 bucks a piece. Then include a few games with them just to get people started, get them hooked. Then, on top of that, microtransactions. 99 cents a piece for every single game in the library. And I don't mean the handful that you'd pick and slowly move out. I mean every game you've got access. Every game you've ever released on any of these platforms in their virtual consoles, throw them on there day one. 99 cents. You know what? I would buy that. I would go through and buy all kinds of games for 99 cents a piece. And I'm sure a lot of you watching this video would probably do the same. And that would have Nintendo raking in all kinds of money. Because they would finally be doing what people wanted. Not this, pay me a subscription and we'll might be generous and maybe, hopefully, eventually, one day when a blue moon shows up and pigs fly, your favorite NES game might show up in this new service as long as you keep paying us that monthly subscription. No, screw that. There's this whole thing going around about games as service. I hate it. I grew up in a time when you bought your game, that was it. You had the whole game. That is still going on in the indie scene. That is still going on for the most part with Nintendo's games. But I am seeing them creep ever so steadily into this whole games as service, live service thing. I'll be honest, that's what this is. But this does have a single player element to it. That is actually really fun. But I did buy it to play the multiplayer. I can't remember any time where I have spent as much time and had as much fun with a multiplayer gaming experience on a console ever until this game. Maybe I would have enjoyed it just as much on the Wii U. I don't know. I got the Wii U after the Switch was released. So, there's that. So, I didn't really get to experience the Wii U in its heyday, even though it's considered a failed console. I do enjoy what I've played with it. I'll be honest, every game I've got installed in there is pirated. I do actually own a few games that I've yet to actually play. Well, no, that's not true. I did play Nintendo Land. Sorry, I'm leaning back and probably messed with the microphone volume there a bit. But, oh, that's going to be the other fun part. I didn't test my microphone when I did this. I hope it sounds okay. Nintendo has the capability, has such capability to rise above their competitors. They're already selling a ton of these things. I'm seeing them kept pretty well stocked at Walmart these days. As much as I hate Walmart. But I want them to do better. I want local backups, and I want a proper virtual console. Local backups is certainly way high up on my list. The virtual console thing, if they do it, they do it. If they don't, well, I've got emulators. I'm serious. I have never really purchased any virtual. I bought a few on the Wii, but never on any of the other platforms. Because I have emulators. I'm not going to spend $5-6 a pop on ROMs that I have for free. Whether I have them legitimately or not, I'm not paying for that. I'm not doing it. I'm not going to pay for a service just for a handful of NES games. I'm not going to do it. I will pay for an online service if I play a lot of multiplayer games, but to be honest, I don't. I played the crap out of this, one, because I was having a ton of fun, and because I didn't have to pay for it. Now that I have to pay for it, I'll be honest, if I got my Switch and it was paid online, I probably would have never bought this game. At all. Because I already knew it was primarily online. This is effectively an online game with a single-player element to it. Not like most games where it's a single-player game with a multiplayer element attached to it. This is the other way around. This is a multiplayer game with a single-player campaign attached to it, which is kind of, in a sense, a tutorial to teach you how to play the game. While also giving a bit of a story and with the world and whatnot. I will still buy Smash Brothers and Mario Kart without online. Because those have amazing single player campaigns. And I can still play local multiplayer. I can take this to someone else who has a Switch and play them without ever paying for online. So at least that's something. Oh, and then there's the whole debacle of the NES library thing having to check into Nintendo every week. Why? Why? What does it matter if you legit if you have the right to access it or not? Why does it need to check in? That goes back to the day of what the Xbox One was promising, that the console would have to check in every 24 hours or it would turn into a giant brick. Making it an always online platform, preventing people who didn't have very good internet, or maybe not consistent internet, or maybe live in areas where internet is not really a thing, from being able to experience the experience games on that platform. I got other issues with the way that Sony and Microsoft are handling their modern consoles, but yeah, I refuse to own the Xbox to ever. Purchased an Xbox One primarily because they were trying to turn it into an always online console. I was leaning towards the PS4, but then I've heard other stuff about the PS4, and I'm like, well, damn, I don't want that console either. I'll just stick to PC gaming with all the crap that I would have to put up with if I owned one of those systems. So, yeah. I don't know anymore. I'm losing faith in the gaming community. I'm losing faith in console manufacturers. I'm losing faith in publishers. I'm losing a lot of faith. And I don't see a light at the end of this tunnel. I don't. I see the indie scene. And I buy most of my games from GOG.com. Because I also don't care for Steam. I just don't know anymore. I grew up loving video games, but these days, I feel a betrayal. I feel betrayed by these console manufacturers and these publishers and all the crap that they're doing. I'm feeling betrayed by Nintendo trying to justify this garbage. Cloud saves are only going to work for a select number of games because we don't want people cheating. You control the platform. It's your service. So instead of being able to protect you, the whole point of cloud saves is the promise that if something happens to this, your saves are still safe. Supposedly. But only the saves for select games. If you put a whole bunch of progress into this and you lose your save, goodbye.
Where did I put that game?
Oh, I picked it up. Okay. Please tell me I'm not the only one that feels this way. Maybe then I can feel a little bit of hope. But as it stands right now, I don't. Day after day, I see all of this stuff going on with around the gaming community. I don't actively follow it. I just get a little piecemeal here and there. But most of it is not good. Sometimes I feel discouraged. A lot of times I feel discouraged. And I just, I hope I'm not alone. It's okay, weird juxtaposition. I hope I am, but I hope I'm not. Because why would I want anyone to feel this way? But if more people do feel this way, then it at least makes me feel better that I'm not unnecessarily getting discouraged by all this, that there is someone else out there. Because then if there are other people out there who feel this way, maybe they'd be willing to fight. I don't know. I don't know what to do. Other than just put this out there for people to see my comments and hope it gets to someone that might be able to do something, but I'm one person, tiny little presence here on YouTube. I'll be lucky if 10 people see this, if they care. I know this goes against the norm of my channel, but I haven't posted a video since December of last year, so. I want to feel like there's hope, but at the same time, not seeing it. I want my cloud save. I want my local saves, Nintendo. I want them on my SD card. I don't want them tied to the internal encrypted storage chip of the Switch, of a device that can break. That in all of me doing this, if I drop it, I lose my saves. How stupid is that? That if I have a small little accident, I lose all of my game progress for all of my games. How stupid is that? Anyway, I should just end this here because I'm sure people have already looked at the time code and been like, oh my god, he talked for how long? And I'm sure I'll get haters, I'll get detractors. It's the internet. There's always haters. God, my hair looks like shit now. But anyway, those are my late night ramblings. And I will see you next video.